All right, we're back, and the mic is on. And we're getting out of bed, and we're checking the weather. All right, weather forecast for tomorrow. Beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Not today. Today it's raining, even though it's bright and sunny out there. Spirits are mildly perturbed today. Uncle Noppy on your side. Boo. Oh, well, I guess if it's raining, then I don't have to water the plants, huh? Nope, looks like they're fine. Let's throw some stuff in there. Stone and coal, we need the geodes. Nope, I want that. There we go, perfect. So yeah, favorite game of all time is a game I've actually played on this stream. Very good. Yeah. Also, let me know if the audio is messed up. I was messing around with it before to try and get it good, and I think I have a good balance, but sometimes it's tough to tell. Dandelion. And a leak. My favorite game of all time is Secret of Mana, the Super Nintendo game. And, ooh. Let's not push to exhaustion again. We don't get a good heal. A good exhaustion heal after that. Good energy heal. Whatever. You know what I mean. Yeah, I played it when it first came out. Forever ago. This is I think it came out in like 91. That's what I want to say. It's not open until 9 a.m. God damn it. And at that point, it was the first RPG that I'd ever played. I didn't play any of the Final Fantasies or anything like that. Dragon Warrior, any of the Nintendo RPGs. It was just a new experience to me, and I played the crap out of that game. endless hours of playing that game. I think it's when I was doing the playthrough, but I told a story of how, like, I just grinded up everybody to max everything, which takes forever in that game. Hello, how are you doing? No, where? Where if I help? Nope, can't help. Alright, fair enough. Oh, it's 9. Let's go crack some geodes. No, the catalyst for me gaming was Super Mario Brothers. Oh, no, not at all. I'm happy to answer any questions that you have. My catalyst for gaming was my cousin, who was 9 years older than me, getting a Nintendo for his birthday. And then me waiting patiently for 4 hours while he and his friends played it to get my turn at it. And I was just mesmerized and decent, so we meet the blacksmith now. It's Clint. Hi, I'm Clint. The town blacksmith. If you ever need to upgrade your tools, I'm your guy. I also heard you're good at cracking geodes, huh? Process some geodes. Just place your geodes on my anvil. I'll take a whack. An earth crystal. Got some malachite. And some clay. Oh, there's a price per geode. Oh, craps. Oh well, a little note here. Stack of metalworking blueprints. Okay. Upgrade tools. Yeah, that's expensive. Shop. I just buy ore, huh? Okay. Your first game was Pong. Taking it old school. Let's try this fishing thing. Got some inventory space now. Woohoo! Oh, I guess it's left click, not right click. I love the story of Pong and how it got started, and let's see, click to raise the bar, release to lower the bar, keep the bar behind the fish. Oh, okay, I control the green bar. Nope. Oh, crap. This is not easy. Hey, we did it! We got a smallmouth bass. Look at that 12-inch beauty. Wouldn't we eat this? Yeah, let's eat it. We're gonna eat this too. We'll eat a daffodil. Get that energy. You know, this gives a ton of energy. Eat it. Chomp. Perfect. I bet you the fish gives energy too. Ooh, it does. But, when Nolan Bushnell, the founder of Atari, and Chuck E. Cheese, if you are not aware, he used to, work for a company that did jukeboxes, or he did something like jukeboxes and bars, basically, is the point of the tale. And, or the key feature of the story, and you know, bamboo pole. I have a bamboo pole. Trout soup, no thanks. Sell you that. Oh. Yeah, sell you all them clams, too. Yeah, I'll sell you that oyster. I don't need that stuff. I just found it on the beach. Cool. And when he started Atari and manufactured some Pong machines, you know, not like in a mass way, just a handful of them, he went on his normal bar jukebox route. He asked all the bar owners if they'd be willing to put up his crazy fangled new invention. Only three people left to meet. We can at least see what their faces look like. And like only a couple accepted. I guess that's the wizard. Here are the three people we've yet to meet. Alright. I guess everybody's gonna be inside already. Oh, the bar. We never went to the freaking bar. Well, here's one. Hello there, I'm Gus, chef and owner of the Stardrop Saloon. Hi there, Stethorel. I'm glad to see you. You're always welcome here. Thanks, buddy. The few that took a chance, well, we got some good results, but there was one in particular where we got a call from a bar owner saying, hey man, your crazy television thing is all busted. You gotta come out here and fix her up. And, hello, where are you? Watering it didn't work. Oh, it would be just like a keg or something. And he thought, like, oh no, somebody vandalized it or something else cool. Right? There's a skull-shaped keyhole. Actually, but no, we do not want a soda thing. Play some pool. So he goes out to the bar and pops open the back to take a look at the electronics because nothing looked wrong on the outside. And he was almost knocked over by a wave of quarters. The machine had gotten so much play. that the bucket, like the empty paint can they used to catch the quarters, had just overflowed and was all in the works of the machine, and it was making it mess up. Oh, you're the new farmer boy, aren't you? Oh, I'm Haley. If it weren't for those horrendous clothes, you might actually be cute. Well, Haley, if it wasn't for your terrible personality, you'd be cute. Sick burn. So, Noam basically, like, gathered up all the quarters in his shirt. Made, like, 3 trips to the car. Let's see, this morning I accidentally stepped on a bug. Oh, no. Have you planted any spring crops yet? The season doesn't last forever, you know. It does not. And then called the people, his partners, people he was working with at the time, to let him know the good news. What am I going to do today? Probably nothing. This is not good weather for sports. It is not. The Pam? Howdy, kids, staying dry? Looking for this, I think Abigail is like the only person we've left to meet. Remember Abigail? Because her mom mentioned her. Oh, there's a little exclamation point here. I'm running low on seaweed. If someone could bring me one, I'd be much appreciated, Pam. Sure. Like a lot of seeds, a lot of peers. Oh, close on Wednesdays! You know, paper boy, just enough for the original Donkey Kong, a local pizza place. Nice. Girl with the purple hair is who I'm looking for. And then they made that Paperboy game. That was a hard game, man. A rough game. Keep my eyes peeled for a purple-haired young lady. Pelican Town. It's locked. Oh, you know, it's probably closed, huh? Library is probably closed. If you're familiar with AVGN, also known as the Angry Video Game Nerd, damn, 6 p.m., just missed him. He and his friend Mike, who worked production on a lot of the Angry Video Game Nerd episodes and played a lot of the secondary characters and things like that. They play games every Monday over on his YouTube channel, Cinemassacre, which is amazing. But also their friend by the name of Bad Luck Bootsy, who occasionally play games with them as well, and they mix and match from time to time. But anyway, point of story is, they played Paperboy recently. Mike and Bootsy played Paperboy recently, to be specific. And it was fun watching them go at it. The old Nintendo version. I remember Paperboy 2 for Super Nintendo. Stepping it up. Let's chop some shit. I guess we'll just burn up some energy in the rain. Don't let the rain bring you down. A geode? It's a geode we can't get. Get out of here, fiber. I don't feel like walking. Crops are looking good. Let's just break some stone for the remainder of the day. I'm going to throw in that stuff for now. I will throw it all in. Alright. So, If you haven't played Harvest Moon, I played it very long time ago. It was basically a game where farming was just one of the mechanics in the game, and there was all this other stuff going on. And you had to meet people, but you had to, like, get... You know, you're trying to help the town and meet everybody in the town. So that's why I'm saying this game point is a lot like... Or why a lot of people are saying this game harkens back to Harvest Moon a whole bunch. So... but if you're ever interested in an old game, Harvest Moon, especially if you want like a bit of a longer experience, Harvest Moon can totally fit that. All right, let's go to bed. We're like all stacked out here. Ooh, found another geode. More wood. You know what? One last thing. Let's fish in our pond. Let's see if we can fish in our pond here. Boom. Come on, fish. Was that? I don't know what the heck that was. Delivery? Did I catch some seaweed? Max! I'm starting to feel exhausted. Was that? I guess that boo was a hit. Alright, one more cast. We got one more cast in us, I believe. Oh, we got trash. Here, let's sell that trash and go to sleep. Alright. Remember the Mega Mans? Yes. Ooh, leveling. Level 1 foraging. Plus 1 accuracy. Some trees drop seeds. New crafting recipe, wild seeds. New crafting recipe, field snack. Pain of your existence, the original Mega Man's. So we know this is a PS4. Let's see. And level 1 mining. Pickaxe proficiency plus 1 and new crafting recipe, cherry bomb. Sweet. Alright, that was worth nothing. Good morning. Weather report. Partly cloudy with a light breeze. Expect lots of pollen. Okay. Fortune teller. Extra luck. Living off the land. This one's for you folks living in Stardew Valley. Check the spring onion. Check for spring onion southwest of town. Where the river meets the ocean, you can sometimes find a whole bunch growing right out of the dirt. I already did. But yes, I love the original Mega Man series, the 1 through 6 on Super Nintendo, particularly 2. A lot of people are very fond of Mega Man 2. I played the crap out of that game when I was a kid. Super hard. Those games are super hard. For a casual playthrough, definitely want to start Metal Man on Mega Man 2, that's for sure. Take that to Bubble Man. Bubble Man goes to Heat Man. Heat Man goes to Wood Man? Wood Man goes to Air Man. Air Man goes to Crash Man. Crash Man goes to Flash Man. And then Flash Man is used for Quick Man. I think that's the loop, and then Quick Man also works for Metal Man, but a little secret for you, Metal Man only takes one hit from his own weapon to kill in the refights, so. You know what, I haven't been up in this field yet, let's go up here. Oh, bus. This is the bus. Out of order, huh? Can we just leave? I'm afraid to walk in here. Nope, won't let us. Bus is out of service. Fair. Oh yeah, we need those jewels. No, Metal Man definitely goes to Bubble Man, and Bubble Man definitely goes to Heat Man. Let me sell some of these oysters too. I just squirrel. I also remember Airman too well, because usually we fought Airman with the Buster. Same thing with Flashman. I usually fought Flashman with the Buster as well. Still looking for Abigail. Shane, what do you want? Leave me alone. Wow, Shane. Plan on spending a lot of time with my telescope this summer. Alright. Is that everybody? No, we're still like missing one person, aren't we? Damn it. Air starting to warm up. Feeling pumped. Get your sports on. We got a little money. Let's crack some more geodes. But first, let's see if there's anybody new in the store. Nope. Yeah, he pushed you away and put all the those tornadoes out in front of you. That was Airman's bag. And Airman killed Crashman for sure. Ooh, some slate and some stone. Hey, oh, little cutscene here. Abysmal. A single piece of the entire collection. What's this? You found something? Let me see it. Remarkable. It's very old. I'd love to study this in greater detail, but it's yours. I've got a favor to ask you. Would you consider donating any new artifacts or minerals that you find? And make a groundbreaking discovery together. Oh, and who knows, if you keep donating, I might come across some interesting items to send your way. Think about it, will you? If you decide to donate, just bring the objects to the front desk. You got it, ma'am. There we go. Let's donate to the museum. What can we donate? Oh. All he wants. Okay. Doesn't seem like you have anything to donate to the museum. Better go out there and do some treasure hunting, huh? Well, you do some treasure hunting, Gunther. I'm doing all the work here. Slight extreme resistance to water, making it good roofing material. Earth crystal, a resinous substance found near the surface. Malachite, a popular ornamental stone used in sculpture and to make green paint. Fair enough. Ooh, done. Archaeology. I ask you to consider donating any new artifacts and minerals to the museum. He says he'll compensate you by way of occasional rare goods. Alright. Let's see. Oh, crap. We have to get that seaweed tour in one day. Let's see if we can work on getting that seaweed. How do we get we have to go to the beach to get it, right? That's the only thing that makes sense. Find some damn seaweed. Can we find it fishing? Washed up on the shore? you know where we can get some seaweed, sir? Hit! No, you don't fish. No, you don't! This is rough. This fish is a fighter. This is a lot harder than it seems. Oh, come on. Yeah, get here, fish. A 1-inch sardine. Yeah, worth 40 monies. A pretty tough fish. All right, we got it. All right, fish, stay down there. Stay down there. Come on. All right, we did it. A 9-inch herring. I'm gonna sell these guys right away. He's only worth 30. Damn. Yeah, I don't know how to get seaweed. I just accepted it, assuming that it would give us seaweed or something. I don't know. Use our axe on this stuff. You can walk up there. Like, I figured it would just give us some seaweed at some point. We watered our plants, right? Yeah. I'm very patient waiting like 10 plus minutes for a fish to bite on one cast. Whoa, whoa, fish. Whoa, fish. Nice. A 1-inch anchovy. We're gonna eat that anchovy. Delicious. Is that spring? It's daytime. If I were seaweed. Where would I be located? Like, it just feels like a thing that you would fish up. Hey! To Pam! Pam lives in the... Shit, does Pam live? This is Lewis's house. Maybe Pam is at the saloon? No, too early for people to be at the saloon. Penny lives there. In here? No, this is George and Evelyn. Lewis is looking at the board. Let's chat with Lewis. So we can get pretty lively at night. Sometimes we even get Queen the Jukebox. Chuckle, chuckle. Alright. Caroline, I wonder if we can get Pierre to cook dinner tonight. So you're a farmer, huh? Interesting. Yeah, it is interesting. Maybe somebody can teach me how to grow vegetables. Okay. Possible. I'm hungry. Where's mom? Right over there, kid. This is Emily. You're farming in a sustainable way. The valley's ecosystem is fragile. Pam here? No. She's probably going to her shift at the saloon. maybe up this way? Crap. Do I even know? Oh, wait, that's right, the map will tell us. I don't know. Carpenter's house. Blacksmith. Mayor's Manor. Elliot's cabin. Don't know yet. Emily and Haley. Jody, Kent, and Sam. Marnie's Ranch, open most days. Wizard's Tower. Crap. Is her husband the blacksmith? Is she single? I don't know. Damn, this is tricky. Oh, there she is! We found her! Hey, Bly, I had one too many caramel porters at the saloon last night. Go away. No, I have your seaweed. Hey, so you saw the ad I posted. Looks perfect. Here's your payment, as promised. Sweet. Sweet! Quest complete. Complete another quest once we find that blue-haired girl. Was it blue-haired? Purple-haired? I think it was purple-haired. I decided I'm going to organize my clothes today. I'll have to throw out all the last year's styles and make room for the new ones. Of course you do, Haley. Of course you do. Yeah, let's hit up the saloon. Maybe, people are partying at the saloon. It's a little early, though. A little early. I like to visit once a week or so to catch up on things anyway. Okay. You're very lucky to have a library in such a small town. Fair enough. When you're lost in a book, it's easy to forget the realities of your life. Maybe that's why I like reading so much. Sorry I carried away out there. That's fine, Penny. I bet you're the one who took that book from the library. Where the shit is that saloon? It's around here someplace. Oh, here it is. Forward to this beverage afternoon. How do you know? How do I know? I have a strong gut feeling. About what? Anyway, I can use a beverage. If I go to the other side, will you? Ah, here we go. Let's go here. Beer? That's expensive. That's an expensive beer. Oh, he sells recipes. Now you don't want to talk. Beer. What? Oh, Journey of the Prairie King. Press space. Wants to move. Shoot. Space item. Are we playing Isaac now? We're playing Isaac on a Super Game Boy. Okay. I'm down. I'll see where this little rabbit hole leads. A lot of men. Got coffee, whatever that does. Oh, it's an item. It's a spacebar item. There's a timer ticking down. We have lives and coins. Can't have an indie game without Isaac and Braid and Super Meat Boy. Hello. Shotgun? That's what it is. Ooh, that coffee made me faster. Oh no! I was gonna get the item. I died once. Okay. we have to use our item here. At least once, right? What? All right, hitboxes. Okay, using it makes you faster. Ooh, hello. A little rapid fire business going on. Tears up. Okay. We have to go down. It's also a little more like Smash TV, I would say. Okay. Oh, we do not keep the shotgun, turns out. Alright, don't let him get sight of you. Just jam him up on these corners. But we're gonna lose items that way. Oh, hello, time stop? I teleport and time stop? Oh, the hitboxes are so incorrect. Oh. You know, a long time to survive on this. Save this item for when things get a little overwhelming. Whoa! Hey, an extra dude! Another extra dude! Looks like we got that star was crazy. And yet another extra. Is that 5 coins? If it is, I can't get it. Which is unfortunate. Ooh, he turned into just like a spike ball. Unfair game. Unfair spawning enemies on my noggin. Oh, gotcha that time. Hey, is this a boss? Oh, it's a shop. I bought something. I don't know what I bought, but I definitely bought it. A better gun? Yeah, I feel like I have a better gun. And like spurry boots. I have items on the left there. Check that out. Ooh, that star. Gotta get that star. Oh yeah, the teleport. I like how you can combine items. That is like a bull or something. Don't know what the star does. Oh, everything. The star does triple shot, movement speed, and the shotgun here. Star's pretty crazy, man. I have to assume that these buffs are timed buffs. Not, like, shot-dependent buffs. Starless, a decent amount of time. Oh, there's a wheel or something I can't get. Bullets though. Oh, hey, the wheel gives you omnidirectional shots, huh? Pretty cool. Alright, we're going down again. Total carnage! I love it! Big money, big prizes. I think Total Carnage was the sequel to Smash TV. Like the even crazier, gorier sequel. If you don't know, Smash TV was a gory game. I don't feel like being in this box is the right call. But for now, it's working because I have the enemies bottlenecked, so I'm gonna stick with it. Oh, just kill everything on the screen. Don't mind if I do. But that was like shotgun wagon wheel combo. It was pretty nice. Pretty nice. Oh no, one up. We lost a one up. Rather unfortunate. We'll deal with the spikies later. The destruction is very real. Hey, another shop. Cool. We get a random item. Oh, do we walk onto the item we want? Well, we have a box down there. Don't know what it does. You'll never take me alive. Oh, we can't cross over. Okay. Whoa. This is like the haunt. Nope, no power-ups here. Whoa, whoa. Yeah, that's it. Stay out in the open. Get wrecked. Always be in cover. Have you ever played XCOM? Yeah! He ain't alive. But we took him. Hey, we got carried off by some bears. Jesus, how long does this go? Oh, we can shoot diagonal. Well, we're in this now. We're doing it. We have 7 lives, and we're playing Isaac all of a sudden. I don't know what this does. This box of business. Well, let's find out. Alright, we got shotgun again. Maybe that box makes items last longer? Oh, that's right. It's the invisibility teleport crap. I think the invisibility thing is worth holding on to for now. I kind of wish these waves were a little shorter. Another shop. Nah, I can't afford anything, so. Boo urns. Give me that coin. Sweet. Gotta upgrade the pistol again. Or for the first time. I have no idea what I bought on my first little escapade of walking into the... Damn it, should have used the item there. Thought I was okay. We've gotten tense quick, though. No, that's okay. We're fine. Mushroom guys are fast. Sweet. Hey, a little coffee. Keep the coffee rush going. Ooh. Keep it going still. Kill everything on the screen. Damn! They kept spawning. What's that? What's that little guy? Get him! Get him! Oh. Okay. Yeah, we need something to cordon some your enemies off on. Oh, you shoot over those bushes, but they can't walk over the bushes. Or maybe I just had the angle appropriate. Oh well. Oh, hello. Some more bottlenecking. But I bet the butterflies don't give a shit because they fly. Yep. Saw what was happening. Writing was on the wall for that one. Still have 6 lives, 12 coins. Like a couple more coins. Like that one. That's a good coin. I think here's an... Oh, that's 5. One of the first 5 coins we've picked up. Oh wow, they're not smart. They're not smart. Oh, I thought I could sneak through. I could not. This is rough. Also, remembering I can shoot diagonally is rough. That is a lot of things. What was that? Lightning bolt. I don't know what that business was. But we got to kill everything on screen, so. Ooh, ooh, we can upgrade the gun, right? Upgrade that gun. Sweet. Good rate of fire now. Trail ends here, cowboy. Does it? Ooh, he got me. Oh man, just stand in the open and get wrecked. Ah, tried to sneak through, couldn't. Probably finish him off here. There we go, we did it. And, let me cross the bridge, please. Thank you for the one up. Crazy skull mask! Yay! Hey, little cute little bear things, carry me away! Oops. I'm glad I upgraded the gun. Yeah, keep those coins coming. I think the next gun upgrade is going to be 30. Jeez. Mummies, tanky, and slow. This is like we're playing a completely different game now. We're just sidetracking the farming and the meeting people and the every other element of this game. We're just gonna play Isaac for a little bit. I wish I upgraded the gun twice. Oh, they go after him. Okay. That was a lot of dudes. I need that star, please. Thank you. Kind of sad I lost that one star. Alright, another one up. This is going well. If you're just joining us, we're playing Stardew Valley, the new Isaac roguelike. Isaac-like roguelike. Available on Steam. For $15. Yeah, gun is 30. We're definitely gonna do gun, because I don't know, like, I guess boots make you go faster, and... Yeah, so on my first, I guess I upgraded the boots first, the first time. And then, I guess, yeah, and then I purposely chose the box by walking into it. There was like a gravestone thing there. Damn it. So much to keep track of, visually. And I'm not used to looking at it yet. Also, holy shit, there was things everywhere. Help that these mummies take 3 hits. Damn it. I think upgrading the box is a mistake. Especially since I don't know what it does. The only thing I can guess is that it makes spacebar items last longer or something. Damn it! Alright, looks like we're on our way out here. We just don't have the firepower to deal with this. This might buy us a minute. We did it. Only 2 doors for this one. But we have all the jerks flying in from the other angles. Didn't want to lose last life with a spacebar item in my hand. That would have been silly. Oh, something spawned from the other side. Oh, alright. Last go here. Jeez! So many dudes! We'll quit. Whoa! That's a shock to the eyes coming back to this. Alright, welcome back to Stardew Valley, the real game. I'm gonna look around one. Well, there was that house up there that was question marks. Let's go to the question mark house and then we'll call it a night. We'll take our second break. I wonder if there's like if that game gives you something, like if it's a special seed packet or at the end or something like that. Would not be surprised. I guess we can't go up there. That's the railroad. We can't go there. Gotcha. That guy's still pickaxing away. All right, let's go back to our farm on the top road again. Over this little overpass. Alright, might as well just grab some more stuff with the pick. Energy. I guess we can knock a tree over here. Alright. Probably want to invest in that bigger backpack, huh? We got an acorn. Oh, it's a seed. Two. Out of season. Oh, excuse me. Into our box. Green algae, huh? It's really slimy. Sure. Maybe make fertilizer or something with it. I'm assuming there's fertilizer in the farming game. One more tree. And then we'll call it a night. Another acorn. I guess those are the seeds they could drop. Gotcha. Alright, off to bed. Yeah, it's time to sleep for the night, I'd say. Nice hard day's work. Alright. Ooh, escape. There we go. So, alright, we're gonna take a second break of the evening. If you're enjoying Stardew Valley / Binding of Isaac on Super Game Boy clone, I encourage you to follow us to know if I would go live again. If you're watching this replay on YouTube, I encourage you to subscribe to know if I have new videos posted. So find me on Facebook and Twitter right up there. I'll be right back after this very brief break.